Hey guys, today I'm excited to bring you an old die for Minecrafter paired with some new release dies. So we're going to be using this Box Pops oval base. You can see on the front. It comes with lots of flowery things, but we're going to do something a little different with it today with the new release. So here is the base part of the die. This fits perfectly on a 6x6 piece of paper. These slits go inside this die to make little tabs where you can attach your stand-up objects. So in this case, these cute little Scotty dogs. And you see how you've got different slits there, so you can make those however you want to and stick a piece of acetate or a piece of cardstock to hold up your little items. This is a really cool die because all of that folds flat to fit in an A2 envelope. These Scotty dogs are part of the new release, and you have two dogs, you have their little eyeballs, the cheers, and some bows to put on them. Okay, when I think of Scotty dogs, I think of black and red plaid. So I'm gonna start with this red, and then we are going to do some more fun things with it. So with this die, you're gonna lay it down, but you have got to attach one of the slit dies inside of this notch. And if you don't do that, it's a little hard to go back and do it. So you wanna tape it down. Do you see the notch right here in the middle where it's attached? Go ahead and tape that so it fits evenly, and then run it through your die machine. I decided to use two pieces of tape, and what I love for this is the post-it note tape. This stuff can go through maybe three different times holding your dies down, which is nice, and you can replace it and adjust it as needed. So a really great thing to have if you're a big die cutter. Here's how this turns out. So when you pull it back over, you gotta untape everything. And when you pull this off, you've got your notch where you put it, and then you have lots of score lines. So these score lines are gonna help guide you through the folding of this. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut out my second one and we'll see what we do from there. So once I've got both of them cut out, I did two different notches so that you could see one of the dogs from behind. I wanted to be a little bit offset. So we'll go over how to fold these, but first we're gonna make our plaid. I'm gonna start with the new buffalo plaid stencil. For Minecrafter that's part of this release, I'm going to use some pixie spray on the back of this, which just helps hold your stencil down. And this is a really long stencil and I'm doing a short area, so I just wanted to make sure I've got it pressed down. The other reason I want to make sure I do pixie spray is because I'm going to use a spray to create this, and I feel like with that you've got to be even more careful that your stencil is pressed down, because sometimes that spray will try to get underneath the stencil. So I'm going to use a Heidi Swap black, and it's actually got some shimmer to it, and I'm just going to spray all of this over here, and I want it to look a little spotty and have a little bit of dimension to it. So you'll see that I'm going to try to cover most of it, but I'm also okay if I get a little less in some areas and more in the other. I don't know if everybody loves a stencil reveal as much as I do, but I love a stencil reveal. So here it is. I'm going to have to set this aside and let it dry. You see up close, you can see those spots where I sprayed, but I want it to look that way. Here's how I cut the strips that I was going to use to decorate. I just put these part of the way through. And one thing I would suggest, this is a very thick cardstock. It would be a good idea to use a thinner cardstock to make this. I ended up using this thicker one and just bending it a lot back and forth so that it'll make that oval and fit along with the other things, because this does make that die a little thicker. Let's start folding this. So I'm just gonna go along with all the score lines. I usually use a bone folder just to make those score lines very, very tight and folded well. So I'm gonna go along and bend all of these using my bone folder. So you'll see it start to take shape here. You can tell what's gonna happen. You've got this folded over as your top piece, and you see that slit that's gonna be in the middle for you to stick some little tabs through. The bottom layer is gonna be your oval base. So that long straight part is your oval base. This is what I'm gonna attach the plaid to. And like I said, I bent this a little bit, just kind of working the paper to make sure that it wants to bend and be able to go flat, that kind of thing. So it's definitely fine to keep bending things, move stuff around, move it back and forth so that you've got something that works and is easy for the recipient. So I'm gonna start gluing on my plaid piece. I'm using a Lawn Fawn glue tube, and you can use any kind of glue you want. You could also use strips of adhesive. I like the glue because I feel like I can kind of adjust where things are, and I feel like sometimes my adhesives that are strip adhesives may come loose, especially on something that's getting moved around this much. So I'm going to attach these little clips to really hold this together since I'm making this part a little thicker than I thought. While I'm letting those dry, I'm going to go ahead and attach this little tab to start folding this. With this, it's inside of this other thing, so it's not an easy place to put a little clip. So what I ended up doing is just holding it together with these glues. A lot of times if you hold it for 30 or 60 seconds, it's going to stay together. But I held this for a while just to make sure, because I know this is a very mobile piece of paper and that little thing is holding it together. So I held this for probably a minute. Now repeat this same part of the process with the other side of the oval. So same thing, gluing down my plaid. I'm going to glue the tab together, hold everything for a little bit to make sure that it stays. Now you should have two halves of your oval, and I'm going to show you how to put those together. So you need to glue the middle of these two together. If you are going to add any extra things in between your two tabs, you want to wait and put those in this middle spot. But for me, I just wanted to do the two dogs on the top. So I went on and glued these together. So same idea, pressure for a little bit holding them together. I actually ended up clipping the sides of these two, and that helps it stay together. You want to give it a little bit of time to dry. So with these clipped together, I still had a slight gap, so I went and put a little bit of extra glue right there and worked that together, just holding it until it dried. While waiting on this to dry, I decided that I'd go ahead and start making my dogs. I thought these would look really cool with some dimension, because when you look at Scotty dogs, they have long flowing hair. And so what I did is I'm using Altenew embossing paste. This paste can be combined with color, and in some later projects you'll see me do that. But today I decided I wanted to do white Scotty dogs. I felt like these would show up really well on that red base. So I'm covering the entire die with this paste, trying to do as thin of a layer as I can, but once I get it on there, I'm going to show you how I added some cute dimension. So this paste is still wet, and so you can put, you know, indentions in it. So I decided I would use the side of my spatula and just make downward strokes how I thought the hair on these little animals would go. And it turned out really good. There's some spots where it'll start to dry a little bit more, so you do need to use a little bit more pressure. But just dabbing like this, you could even just dab with the bottom of your spatula, not making it look like it's flowing fur, and just give this guy some fluffy tufts of hair. It's really a cool thing, and I think it turned out really well. I'm going to show you in an up-close picture. Here he is up close. I'm going to freeze frame it for you, and I'm just cleaning up the edges, but look at those little lines of hair. I think it's so cute. I let this Altenew embossing paste dry for an hour or two, so I wanted to make sure to get all the rest of the card done. So I cut out my sentiment cheers, and I thought, I just want to put a little highlight behind it to make it stand out even more. But I think this matte silver paper looks really good with this, and I think it would make a great holiday card. It could be New Year's, it could be a Christmas card, but I think it just looks great. And I just used another die cut of the word cheer and made it a shadow. So just kind of slightly offset it when I was putting them together. And I thought that made it stand out just a little bit better and look really cool. So to make the bows have a little bit of sparkle, because I feel like every holiday card needs a little extra sparkle, I'm using some Stickles paste. I could have done this a lot of different ways, but this is a new paste of mine that I wanted to see how the sparkle worked. I thought that it would be easier just to rub this on the lid versus making an entire piece of sparkly paper, but I think it turned out really cute. The bows that you see laying there, so the one on the left is what the die cut looks like. It's got two sizes like that. But they look really good when you put them together. So on the right, I decided to show you what it looks like with two. Now I've cut out two acetate tabs, as you can see right here, and we've got to align our dogs. I went on and put my dog that goes in the back through this tab, but I'm going to kind of show you. I feel like the one on the front is the one you really have to pay attention to. So it's got a natural fold, but I have trimmed it and made it a little bit shorter. And then I want to line up my dog and make sure that he's not blocking the other dog too much. He is a little bit, but as much as he can. And you also want to make sure he fits when you fold. So I'm putting him here. There's a lot of acetate that sticks out behind him, and I'll go back and trim that off, but I'm just going to glue him. I use some adhesive strips and some liquid glue to glue him to this. Let's put the sides of our oval box together. So it's got tabs on the side. I did cut out a new piece because I lost my original video. But you see there's a tab right here and a little hook. So you're going to hook that in there. And then you've got to fold this over and glue it. You could glue those before you hook them in the tab. I had a harder time holding onto it that way. So this way I can really hold the sides and wait for that glue to set up. And you'll see it once it's completely finished. I probably held this for a minute, and there you go. That's what your box looks like. This will fold perfectly in an A2 card, and I'll show you the final results next. Here are the final photos. I hope that everybody enjoyed this video and got something useful out of it today. I really had a lot of fun making these dogs, and I'm going to be doing some more projects for iCrafter. Stay tuned for that, and make sure that you check the description for all the products that I use today. Those have some links that give me a small commission, and would love for you to click through those if you're going shopping today. Have a great day. I'll see you soon.